I think we'll go to the tutorial. So let us just try to do ourselves a couple of problems. Tutorial 1 problem is displayed. So again, determine the forces in members FH, EH, EG, LM, MK and LK. So you could either do by method of joints or you could do by method of sections as well. So I just need the numbers, at least for if we can just work out FH, EH and EG, that will be more relevant. Just solve FH, EH and EG, take any method, but again the main point here, these three members are actually at the middle of the truss. So therefore, as we all know, that method of section would be more appropriate to solve for these three forces. If you are done, you can just type your answer in the Moodle or in the chat. Type your answer in the chat for FH, EH and EG. I will be interested in the one of these forces at least. Please mention in the bracket tensile or compressive, okay? Tension or compression should be mentioned. Don't put plus minus sign. As I said, plus minus sign is very irrelevant. Please always indicate your answer by T or C. So I see some of you are giving the correct answers. So FH will be 160 kilonewton compressive. Okay, I'm displaying the solution because we won't take much time here, because as I said, you can do it as a homework also, but glad to see that many of you are posting the correct answers. So the purpose is solved here. So let's just look at the solution. It is being displayed already. So just look at it, how the method of sections are being okay, FH, EH and EG can be solved by passing this section, as you can see here. So this has been solved. Okay, we can easily take, let's say I want to solve for FH, so I can take a moment about E. Once I take moment about E, we can solve it. So 160 kilonewton compressive, okay, because the reason it is negative, because I have chosen it already, you know, in tension. So this is already considered positive, but it came out as negative. So therefore, you know, it is a compressive force. Similarly, FEH is 200 kilonewton, okay. And for FLK and FMK, you can simply use joint M and joint L. So that will lead to these two problems, okay. MK and LK can be solved by based on method of joints, okay. So solution will be posted on the Moodle as well. So we'll move to the next one, just one more quick exercise. As such, it will be simple. We understand there may be some problem viewing the solution, plus we don't worry, the solution is posted on the web. See, our main purpose of the tutorial session, as I said before also, that we want to do some brainstorming together. That's all. So we want to solve a problem in a definite period of time. There may be some homework or exercises that can be done separately, you know, at home or as a homework. But here we have to get the main concept and we have to find an answer within a definite amount of time. Can we now do this? Let's say I want to find BD and DE, then what kind of section I am going to take? Okay, so I am getting answers from different centers, yeah. both BD and DE will be tensile force and their answer is 180 kilonewton. Both BD and DE, they are tensile in nature and magnitude is 180 kilonewton. Someone just wrote 180 kilonewton compression, that's not correct. Okay. Should be tensile force. So the simplest way to solve would be, you see the point here is you could get the reaction here, but if you avoid, if you try to avoid even solving for the reactions, you know, you should take first a section through BD, DE and EG. So we should take a section through BD, DE and EG and take the upper half of it. So take the equilibrium of the upper half of the body. So let's try to look at the solution here. Yeah, so solution is displayed here in your video. So try to take a section through BD, DE and EG, that will expose these forces. BD, DE and EG will be exposed and you can take the upper half of it, that means A, B, E, C, that portion we have taken out. So now it's, you can see clearly, I have to find out F, B, D and F, D, E, right. So as I can see clearly, just very fast solution I can obtain by simply taking the equilibrium along the x direction. So if you look at the equilibrium along the x direction, okay, so that is 180 kilonewton. Remember, here I have already taken this as a tensile force because this is outward direction. So member is in tension, therefore I have FDE solved, and therefore now FBD, how do I solve FBD? Simply take moment about E, right. So idea all the time is how can I solve the given unknown using one equilibrium condition. Okay, so if you take moment about E, then I can solve FBD directly, that will be 180 kilonewton. Is that clear? So now next I am going to give a little bit challenging problem and just try to spend maybe few more minutes, okay. So now you will see that method of joints and method of sections will fall apart or it is difficult. Just one hint, A, B, C, D, E, F, everywhere you have pins. And C, F, B, F, they are continuous members. So there is no pins at the intersection. So B, C, you know, C, F, B, F, A, D, A, E, they are continuous members. There is no pin connection at the intersection. So you can attempt to solve this problem using method of joints or method of sections and try to see what is the consequence, or you can try to identify what are the simple trusses. Is that a compound truss? Can I identify two simple trusses that are jointed together by various members? So that's the hint. Once you identify the two simple trusses, you can detach them and try to solve this problem. First part, you must solve for the reactions. From the global equilibrium, we can solve for the reactions from the global equilibrium. So I try to adopt the concept of compound truss here. A, D, E and B, C, F, these are two simple trusses. You see basic triangular truss A, D, E and B, C, F. Now simply detach them and try to work on the equilibrium. You will see how simple it is to solve for the desired forces. So far I have only received probably one correct answer, and that answer is F AB equals to 0. The force in member AB equals to 0 I got. Now people are writing actually, okay, you need more time. No matter, okay, just take another 2-3 minutes. At least give me one or two forces based on the concept delivered. Okay, I think I will start showing the solution. As I said, try to get the concept. Some of you are giving correct answer. AB is 0, F, so only thing here I see F AB, if you want to, F BC will be 0 also, okay. So just try to see how we have done this problem. First we get the reactions definitely. So the first part here is to get the reactions. Get the reactions. AY will be 0. Vertical reaction at A is 0. You will have a AX. Okay. And then you will have a reaction here also. So now what has been done? Just detach one of this truss. I mean, I have detached here A, D, E. If you detach A, D, E now, you will see there are three unknowns. That is F, C, D, F, E, F and F, D, A. So therefore, these three unknowns can be solved by taking the equilibrium of this. So the free body that I am really looking for is shown here. Remember, this is ADE, which is a basic triangular truss. That's the free body I am really looking at. Okay. So once you get the reactions from the past part, just analyze this one. We should be able to get FAB very quickly, FCD. Just take the sum of force along x 0, okay. So that's the, you know, basic thing that we have discussed, how to solve the compound truss. Now you can look at the solution afterwards, but ultimately idea was, can we solve a compound truss problem? That is done, okay. So I will give one more problem, but that's a homework problem. You can look at the next problem. And we can discuss this even towards the end of this workshop, okay. So we can, you can simply look at, there is another problem I am sharing with you. Just the next problem is again a compound truss problem. So this problem, you can work it out as a homework problem. Just take it home. We will push the solution. But remember what will happen, I will just give a hint. ADE is a simple truss. And EFI is another simple truss, they are connected here. As I said, remember there is a hinge here, I have two unknowns here, I have two unknowns here. Problem just can't be solved using method of section so easily, or method of joints, I can't start because first I have to solve for the reaction. Now remember there are two reactions here as we discussed, this was in the lecture problem also. During the lecture we discussed there are two reactions. Can you tell, can you type in the chat what is the value of EY, what is the reaction in the vertical direction as you detach these two bodies? The problem is symmetric. So just think about, if I detach this, what is the vertical reaction at Y, E? What is the vertical reaction at E? What is the value of EY? Okay, once that is understood, lot of centers now responding. The EY, if you detach it and draw the free body, the vertical reaction will be 0. Okay, and that will be the, you know, starting point to solve this problem. Then you can try to use method of sections and all that, method of joints to get the member forces. As such, one more thing, can you solve for CE without even going to the concept of compound truss? Can I solve for the CE directly? CE can be solved by taking a section through CD, CE and EK. If I do that, take a section through CD, CE and EK, use method of section here and take a moment about A. Take a moment about A. You see CD and KE will pass through A. Therefore, you can solve CE even if you do not want to go to the compound truss. Now, once CE is solved, now you see I have to solve from here actually to solve the other unknowns like KE and D or whatever other forces are asked. Okay, so that is the approach. So, one thing is that still you are able to calculate the CE through method of section, but to get the other forces, now I have to get the horizontal reaction at E. To solve for KE, I should get the horizontal reaction at E. Okay.